Welcome to this morning's meeting of the Senate Committee on Aging. It's Tuesday, May 11th, 2021. I'm Senator Rachel May, chair of the committee, and I would like to welcome and thank all of our committee members for joining us remotely, as well as all viewers who are joining today through the Senate online broadcast of the meeting. In attendance today, we have the ranking member, Senator Sue Cirino, and we're also joined by Senator Baruch, Senator Felder, Senator Serrano, Senator Borrello, and I think it's Senator Addabbo. Oh yes, Senator Addabbo as well. Welcome. Before we begin the regular business of the meeting, I understand that Senator Cirino has something she'd like to address.
Thank you, Senator May. You know, respectfully, once again, I'm asking to move a motion to issue a subpoena to the New York State Health Commissioner Howard Zucker to testify before us and to bring with him a certain recording and records of interest. Honestly, I hope by now advancing such a motion would be unnecessary, yet here we are in May and there's been no answers or accountability for the thousands of families who have lost their loved ones to COVID in our nursing homes. In February, I filed a Freedom of Information Law request to compel the release of the transcript, as well as a complete recording of the February 10th meeting between the members of your conference and the governor's top officials. Within days of submitting that request, a rushed transcript was publicly released. Despite that public release, last week I received a letter from the FOIL office denying my request on the grounds that releasing any actual recording would somehow be problematic. This denial only raises more questions and leads us to assume that something in a recording of the meeting or in its records does not match the transcript that was released to the public. New Yorkers deserve absolute transparency on this issue. Yet to date, the committees that can take action to get to the bottom of how and why decisions were made that impacted nursing home residents during the pandemic have refused to leverage their full power to do that. You yourself come from the world of academia, Madam Chair. At the very least, don't you think we owe it to those who have been impacted to perform a complete top to bottom review of the state's handling of the COVID crisis in our nursing homes? Without that, we can't set effective state policy and we can't be fully prepared going forward. In the February 10th transcript, you're quoted as saying, "The issue for me is feeling like I needed to defend or at least not attack an administration that was appearing to be covering something up." Well, all these months later, thanks to whistleblowers and the press, we know that the cover-up is real. Unless you're still feeling that kind of pressure, what reason is there not to take up this motion today? And while the governor wants to argue this push is all about politics, for me and thousands of devastated families, it's always been about people and improving the policies that impact them. We have the opportunity to do right by them today, and I respectfully ask for a second.
Madam Chair, I'd like to second Senator Cirino's motion. Let me say that it's ridiculous that we have had to spend valuable time in this session trying to pry information out of the governor's office and about something as important as this. We all know that this last 4 months have been unending scandals and unanswered questions, and we have the power here to do this now, okay? Rattling sabers in front of TV cameras is not where we get this done. We get it done here in Albany with this committee by approving this motion so that we can have a subpoena issued to have Dr. Zucker, Melissa DeRosa, and everyone else appear before this committee. And, you know, let's talk about this partial transcript, this FOIL request that was denied. You know, there's several missing minutes from that transcript, which really reminds me of another recording where several missing minutes were missing. And certainly that's the Watergate scandal that brought down an entire presidency. And in that case, it was merely about somebody breaking into a hotel, not about the life and death decisions, bad decisions that were made by this administration that cost the lives of countless seniors in New York State. So I'm going to second this motion for this subpoena, and I'm going to respectfully ask that all of you that have rattled your sabers in front of the camera now step up and do the right thing where the job is actually done, and that's here in Albany. Thank you.
All right, thank you. As chair, it is my prerogative. I'm going to rule this motion out of order pursuant to Rule 7, Section 2. I also will mention that having been part of that conversation, the transcript is quite accurate and as complete. There's nothing missing that I'm aware of from that transcript. So in any case, I rule it out of order. Do you wish to appeal the ruling?
Yes, I respectfully appeal the ruling of the chair. And Madam Chair, if I could just ask one question as well. On March 5th, Senator Skoufis released a statement saying that as investigations chair, he supported moving forward with another hearing in coordination with this committee and the health committee and would exercise his committee's oversight authority. I was wondering where that effort stands.
My understanding is that the Assembly's impeachment inquiry took precedence over that. So we are waiting for the various investigations that are ongoing, including an FBI investigation to run their course. So that's my understanding.
Okay. And just as legislators,
but I don't want to get into a back and forth here. That there is a ruling by the chair. You are appealing it. Please be succinct.
Okay, thank you. I'm good.
Okay. Well, then the ruling of the chair holds, and I ask the members of the committee to vote on the procedural ruling. All in favor of supporting the ruling of the chair, ordering this motion out of order, please say aye. All opposed? Okay, the motion or the chair's ruling carries and we can move on with our business. Let's turn to the agenda now. We have 9 bills for consideration this morning. Our first bill is Senate Bill 554 by Senator May.
This bill amends the elder law and the economic development law in relation to Encore entrepreneurship.
And I will mention this is a bill that passed 2 years ago and was vetoed by the governor, but we are reviving it in hopes that he will change his mind. Is there a motion?
Move the bill.
Senator Addabbo and seconded by Senator Brook. Any discussion? Any questions? Can't really see my script and everybody at the same time. All in favor of reporting the bill? Any AWR opposed? All right, the bill is reported to finance. Our second bill is Senate Bill 1106 by Senator Stuart Cousins.
This bill amends the real property law in relation to prohibiting the termination of tenancy in certain housing occupied by senior citizens and or persons with disabilities.
Is there a motion?
Brook.
Senator Brook? Second. Senator Addabbo, thank you. And any discussion? No. Okay, all in favor of reporting the bill? Everyone's so quiet. All opposed? Anyone AWR?
AWR, Madam Chair.
Okay, Senator Borrello and Senator Serino are AWR. This bill is reported to first reading on the calendar. Our third bill is Senate Bill 2535 by Senator Rivera.
This bill amends the elder law in relation to program eligibility for plans comparable to Medicare Part D.
Do I have a motion?
Bill.
Senator Addabbo and Senator Serrano seconds. And any discussion? No? Okay. Well, all in favor of reporting the bill to finance. Okay, anybody opposed? AWR? All right, the bill is reported to finance. The fourth bill is Senate Bill 2823 by Senator Serino.
This bill amends the elder law in relation to the duties of the Office for the Aging to provide certain information relating to those services through electronic means.
I'll move the bill.
Okay, do I have a second? Senator Brook, and any discussion? Senator Serino, do you want to say anything about this bill?
Thank you for putting the bill on. I appreciate it very much.
Pleasure, it's a good bill. So all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, opposed? AWR? All right, bill is reported to finance. Our fifth bill is Senate Bill 4216 by Senator Stavisky.
This bill amends the real property law in relation to tax abatement for rent-controlled and rent-regulated property occupied by senior citizens or persons with disabilities.
Is there a motion? Senator Addabbo, Senator Serrano seconds it. And any discussion? No? Okay. All in favor of reporting the bill? Anyone opposed or AWR? No? Okay. Mm-hmm. The bill is reported to finance. Our sixth bill is Senate Bill 5196B by Senator Sanders.
This bill amends the elder law in relation to providing elder abuse prevention training.
Is there a motion? Senator Addabbo, seconded by Senator Brook. Discussion? This is part of a series of bills about elder abuse that is such a major and growing problem in the state and across the country. So all in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed or AWR? No, the bill is reported to first reading on the calendar. The seventh bill is Senate Bill 6260 by Senator Rivera.
This bill amends the real property law in relation to expanding eligibility for tax abatement for rent-controlled and rent-regulated property occupied by persons with disabilities.
Do I have a motion?
Oh, I'm sorry, comment? Is it? I'm sorry.
Let's move it first. And then
okay,
we'll
sorry.
Do I have a motion? Senator Brook, seconded by Senator Serrano. Okay, now discussion.
Yeah, thank you. I think this is a very commendable idea. However, I am always troubled by people that are self-reporting, basically self-attestations, and that always concerns me when it comes to fraud and abuse. So I'm just curious, the way I read the bill, that this is a self-attestation. There is no confirmation of the actual claim. Just wondering if maybe someone on staff can address that.
Hi, Senator. Not a problem. So the certification process requires two elements. One, it is a self-attestation, you're correct, but it also requires that the applicant's healthcare provider affirms the applicant has a severe disability to the point to where they can't work, pretty much. So yes, they have to sign something, and yes, that would be related to fraud if it were found that they didn't have a disability, but they also have to have a doctor saying, confirming that there is a disability in existence.
But there is no no one at social services or any other state agency will actually double check that confirmation by whatever healthcare provider. Is there any standard which healthcare provider, or could just anybody that has a some kind of a certification as a healthcare provider?
Yeah, I mean, of course, you'd have to be licensed in the state, but outside of that, there's not a lot in this section of law that describes that. I'd have to look into that further if there's more elements in existence outside of the framework of this bill.
Okay. And again, I think it's a laudable goal. I just am concerned about the potential for fraud. So I'm going to be AWR today. Thank you.
All right. Any other discussion? So all in favor of reporting the bill?
Aye.
Opposed? AWR, other than Senator Borrello, Senator Serrino is also AWR. Okay. The bill is reported to finance. And the eighth bill is Senate Bill 6526 by me.
This bill amends the elder law in relation to the definition of social adult day services. This bill is a departmental from the agency, from the office.
Do we have a motion? Senator Addabbo, seconded by Senator Brook. And any discussion of this bill? This just makes it more clear. Well, it adds some definitions to social adult day services so that day services in homes can be included. So, all right. All in favor of reporting the bill?
Right.
Anyone opposed or AWR? All right, the bill is reported to first reading on the calendar, and our ninth and final bill is Senate Bill 6528 by Senator Persaud.
This bill amends the elder law in relation to establishing an elder abuse enhanced multidisciplinary team program under the auspices of the State Office for the Aging. This is also a departmental.
And do I have a motion? Senator Borello, seconded by Senator Addabbo. And any discussion? Senator Serino.
I've been a long supporter of the EMDTs, and it's great to see this bill on today. So thank you. Thank you to Senator Prasad.
Great. All right. All in favor of the bill?
Yes.
Anybody opposed or AWR? No. Okay. The bill is reported to finance. I want to thank all the members. This will be the last meeting of the Aging Committee for the year. Please do make sure that the clerk has your voting sheets. And I want to thank our clerk, Kristen Williams, and our counsel, Maria Morrissey, for all their support this year. Thanks, everybody.